depreciation theory still continues, and we start with block of asset. What do you mean by block of asset? Let's see it over here. What does block of asset mean? Block of asset. Please don't draw what I am drawing. If you want, you can draw it somewhere over here. I am drawing it in the main section. So see, what does block of asset mean? There are 10 ACs. So this become a block. Okay, there are 10 air conditions. There are 10 ACs. It become a block. So all these 10 AC become a block of asset. The block of asset means block of AC. Okay. Similarly, if 10 plant and machineries are there, then it become block of plant and machinery. So there is possible that in this block, two plant and machineries are added. And there is also a case where two machineries or one machinery is got obsoleted or got destroyed by some means. So one is subtracted. So finally, in this part, block of asset, there is a little capital gain part also that I have told you I'll be teaching you in the PGPP. So let's see in the block how to calculate capital gain. First, we'll see that how to calculate capital gain. I'll make simple for you. If in the question it is given block of asset, so it simply specifies that to you that no long term capital gain will come, only short term capital gain will come if block of asset is there, because you won't be able to recognize which asset came recently and which asset was sold recently. So simple, they have made it simple. The Income Tax Act has made it simple and said if block of asset is there, then no long term capital gain, only short term capital gain. So let's see block of, again I'll be again writing, I just wanted to make you all understand what block of asset means. Block of asset, a T diagram. I have to make a T diagram over here because I'll be writing theory after this. I'll give you in a para format also. To make you all remember, I have to write first in tree diagram. All asset sold. This is capital gain part. Okay. Partial capital gain part and PGPP part. So all asset sold, part of asset sold. Or I'll write partial asset sold. If you are selling the assets, there are this possible cases: over recovery and under recovery. You understand what this means? Over recovery and under recovery, I guess. Partial asset sold and over recovery. I'll be teaching you all what is this over recovery and under recovery is. So don't worry if you are not understanding what I am speaking. So all assets sold, if the cost is assume rupees 100 rupees and you have over recovered, that is you have sold it for 120, all assets sold and over recovered, that is 20 rupees over recovered, then 20 rupees will become short term capital gain. Okay, and since all the assets are sold, there is no asset remaining, so therefore in future there will be no depreciation. Okay, I'll be writing over here, so just for making you understand, if I have sold all the assets sold for of cost 100, but under recovery it is sold for 90, then 10 rupees, that this will become short term capital loss. Okay, 10 rupees will become short term capital loss. And since all the assets are sold, no depreciation. So let, if you understood over recovery and under recovery, then I'll continue ahead. I hope you all have understood. So if over recovered, then it will become short term capital gain. And in bracket right, there will be no asset in the block. So there will be no depreciation. ओके, इन अंडर रिकवरी शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल लॉस एज आई टोल्ड यू ओवर 10 rupees कैपिटल लॉस, बट ऑल द एसेट्स आर सोल्ड, देर विल बी नो एसेट इन द ब्लॉक, सो देर विल बी नो डेप्रिसिएशन. आई होप दिस मच इज क्लियर. आई एम टीचिंग टू IPC स्टूडेंट्स, सो आई होप यू ऑल आर दिस मच स्मार्ट इनफ टू अंडरस्टैंड. आई होप दिस मच इज क्लियर. सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू पार्शियल एसेट्स सोल्ड. सो इफ फ्रॉम द ब्लॉक यू आर सेलिंग 50 rupees एसेट, रिमेनिंग 50 इज देयर, एंड यू हैव ओवर रिकवर्ड, यू हैव सोल्ड इट फॉर 60 rupees, 10 rupees यू हैव ओवर रिकवर्ड, सो दैट 10 rupees विल बिकम शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन. वॉट इट विल बिकम शॉर्ट टर्म कैपिटल गेन, सिंस देयर आर एसेट, since there are asset, but since it is over recovered, since there are asset and there will be no depreciation, simply take this, or I'll make it more simple for you all so that you can keep it in your mind. If 100 rupees assets are there, you are selling partial assets, that is 50 rupees assets are only sold, and 100 rupees you have recovered, that is the total cost of the assets you have recovered, capital gain you have done of 50 rupees. Since you have over recovered everything, you have over recovered the cost also, the cost of rupees 100 of all the assets, this simply says that you have asset but there will be no depreciation. Okay, I'll be giving you all the theory, don't worry, this is for your comfort level, so that you are comfortable with this chapter. If you have under recovered totally, if you are selling partial 50 rupees assets only and you have recovered only 40 rupees, that is 10 rupees short term capital loss, and there is asset and there will be depreciation because 50 rupees asset is still remaining. Okay, so short term capital loss, since there are asset and under recovered the remaining assets will be charged depreciation. I hope this much is clear. Please copy it down. I hope you all have copied this much. So now the theory part, the para part, I'll be showing you all. This was in the view of capital gain, short term capital gain, short term capital loss, short term capital gain, short term capital loss. The remaining was the PGPP part. Now specifically the PGPP part and the capital gain part, both together in the theory format, in the para format, will be given to you all. See, case 1, over recovery of cost of the assets and over recovery of the WDV of the asset. First, let me explain this. This box is an asset purchased / cost is rupees 200. Now WDV, because depreciation is already charged on it, so I don't need to write again WDV. WDV is 100, but while selling the asset, you over recovered of the cost, that is you got rupees 300 while selling the asset, so you have over recovered the cost as well as over recovered the WDV. So how you will account it in the income tax? So let's see. Excess over, you can write this example in the fair also, एक्सेस ओवर कॉस्ट, एक्सेस ओवर कॉस्ट दैट इज 300 माइनस 200 इज इक्वल टू 100 विल बी टेकन एज व्हाट, व्हाट कैपिटल गेन, ओके, एंड एक्सेस ओवर WDV till cost that is 200 minus 100 is equal to 100 will be taken as business income. So this income will be allowed. So I'm putting a star with the pen over here. So if in the exam it is said you have an asset and you have over recovered the WDV, if you have over recovered the WDV till the cost, then such over recovery will become the business income and such business income is allowed, okay, for computation of the net profit. This was the first case. Now let's start with the case 2. Over recovery of WDV, but under recovery of cost, that is excess over WDV till cost will be taken as business income. This all I am writing. There is one more case. I am writing the remaining two cases. Just you should know it. That's why you should write in your book so that when you read it is, it will become easy for you. By explaining the case when you have understood what it is, the what the concept is, you have understood. I hope you have understood, and I'm quite confident that by explaining you the case when I have completed explaining you all everything. Now only the third case is very important. The case 2 was not so important. Now case 3 is bit important. Now see what you will do in case of under recovery of WDV and under recovery of cost. Now see, under recovery of WDV and under recovery of cost, under recovery of WDV will be taken as terminal depreciation. What it will be taken? Terminal depreciation. There was a question in a practice manual in a previous book. I have seen the previous book when I was studying. So here let's understand what is this. You have purchased the asset for, that is the cost, rupees 200, WDV is rupees 100, but recovered is rupees only 70. That is 100 minus 70 comes to rupees 30. It becomes your terminal depreciation. This amount will be allowed as depreciation. The 30 rupees, please write this example. The 30 rupees will be allowed as depreciation as calculated under Income Tax Act. Please write the theory. I have given you the example. Please incorporate this example in this case 1. Pause the video and copy. I hope you have copied. Copy the case 3. Copy this also. I hope you all have copied.